I've been wanting to try a 3D printer for some time. I didn't want to break the bank, but wanted something that might provide pretty good prints. The Monoprice Select Mini 3D printer had good reviews, and for $200 it seemed like a good choice. So far, I'm very happy. There really isn't much to setting up the machine. Just carefully remove from the box and connect the filament rack. Then you'll need to verify the build platform is level. Just use the control to move the build platform and extrusion head to home. Use a spacer that is 0.05 millimeters thick. I use the backing from some labels. It is fairly stiff and exactly the right thickness. The screws may be covered with tape. Just lift the corner and cut it so the screw is visible. I have blue painter's tape on my build platform with the corners cut. Move the build platform and head to each corner and check the space between the head and the build platform. Move the build platform enough to access the screw. When the spacing is correct, the paper will move between the build platform and the head with just a little drag. To adjust, turn the screw a little clockwise to increase the gap, or turn the screw counterclockwise to decrease the gap. Recheck each corner after making adjustments, and readjust as necessary until you feel a little drag on the paper at each corner. Next, insert the filament. The directions suggest cutting the filament at an angle to help it go through the tube smoothly. I recommend just heating a small section slightly and drawing it into a taper. Then cut the taper to make a rounded end. The taper seems to go through the tube smoother since it has no sharp edges. Feed the filament into the machine by squeezing the lever to release the feed mechanism and push the filament through. It will stop at the extrusion head. If you turn on the preheat to the melting point of the filament, you can push a little through so you know it is in the right spot. After getting the printer ready, I did what most new users would do. I printed the cat sample and then downloaded and printed some samples from Thingiverse.com. Everything printed well. To print a model, just copy the G-code to the micro SD card. Insert the card into the slot on the right side of the printer. Set up the preheat temperatures for the extrusion head and the build platform. When the temperatures are up, select Print and select the model you want to print. What I really needed was a project of my own. The lamp on my scroll saw had broken, and I replaced the socket and lamp with an LED socket and lamp. I modified the old shade so I could use it by sticking it on with duct tape. I wasn't too happy, so I decided that would be a good 3D project. I decided this project would be a good one to test openSCAD, a free modeling program. It isn't the easiest program to start with, but does a good job. I won't go into the detail on using openSCAD. Basically, I made the shade of three parts, the rounded end, which is a 1/4 sphere, the 1/2 cylinder, which forms most of the shade, and the base of the shade, which has a slot to fit over the flex arm holding the lamp on. I then made a mount for the lamp that would fasten to the flex arm. It is made of two parts, the top going over the arm, and the flat base that will screw to the top. The shade will then be held to the mount with bulldog clips to make it easy to remove. When the model of the part has been created in openSCAD, you render it and then export as an STL file. The STL file is then opened in Cura, one of the programs that comes with the 3D printer. With Cura, you can arrange your model on the printer build platform and verify that everything will work properly. You get an estimate of the printing time and the amount of filament used. You can look for overhangs and show the layers as they would print. The overhangs show up in red. As you will see, even these overhangs print fine because of the curved surface. When you've arranged your model and verified that it is what you want, you export the G-code, which is the code that drives the printer. I found Cura very easy to use. One of the nice things about it is it offers an abundance of help just by hovering over any field. You'll get help for that field. When you first install Cura, you'll set up a machine profile for your printer. It looks something like this. In that, you'll set the various parameters that your printer can accept. Cura can also scale a model. So the SketchUp version of the lampshade I scaled to 25% to make a time lapse. When I print a model, I normally use the Raft option. The Raft is several layers between the build platform and the model. It helps the model adhere to the platform. I prefer it because it is much easier to lift the model from the platform, and the raft is easy to remove from the model. Thank you for viewing. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to my channel.